Hello viewers, welcome to your number one learning channel, Elimu TV, a station where we watch and learn. This is our history class, our lesson 4 on transport. And now, last lesson, we did look at traditional forms of transport. But again, today we'll get to look at the modern means of transport. And as always, it is your tutor, Rajab Mishira. Welcome all. Now, by the end of the lesson, what do we expect as a class? What we need is that we need to be able to describe, or rather discuss, the trend of development of the modern rail transport, and also get to give some of the advantages and disadvantages of railway transport. Let us hit the road. What is this rail transport? So the development of the modern railway transport, it was a gradual process. In this case, it means it developed from simpler machines to a more advanced machines, or rather, the railway in that case. Now, if we can get to see, the first ever railway to develop, or rather to start, was the Stephenson Rocket. This one was in Germany, and mostly it was used in coal mines. It was just a simple engine, right? It was a simple engine that could be used in the coal mines. Now, from a Stephenson rocket, we went to a diesel engine, right? And a diesel engine, mostly in Africa, it was brought by the colonial powers. Right now, and as you can see a diesel engine there. From the word diesel, it produces a lot of smoke, and that is mostly what in Kenya we have the diesel engine that produces a lot of smoke. For example, here in Kenya, the Kenya-Uganda railway, all along from Mombasa to Kampala, Uganda, they used the diesel engine, right? It produces a lot of smoke, and it has got a number of cargoes. Then from a diesel engine, it later developed into the electric train. We have got electric trains here. For example, in Ethiopia, they have an electric train. Talk of Japan, talk of the United States of America, right? Talk of those developed countries. They have the electric train. And also, not forgetting that Kenya, we don't have an electric train, but we have this modern kind of engine that was developed recently. The standard gauge railway, right, is another modern engine. But again, it also produces smoke. It is not like the electric train. However, we must note that the electric train is also fast, right? It is also fast. It travels 360 kilometers per hour. So you can get to see how fast the electric engine is. Now, onto that, can we get to look at what are some of these advantages of the rail transport, right? One, it is suitable for transportation of heavy, bulky goods. For example, talk of the containers, right? From the port Mombasa to the dry port in Naivasha. So it transports heavy, bulky goods. Then also it is economical for transportation of goods and services over long distance, right? So it carries a number of goods, right, at cheaper cost. For example, the standard gauge railway from Mombasa port to the dry port in Naivasha, that one container, it takes 10,000 shillings. So you can get to see how economical it is as compared to road transport. And also, electric trains is a fast means of transport. And as I said earlier, that the electric trains travels at 360 kilometers per hour. So you can get to see how fast the electric trains are. And also, it is the safe means of transport, as accidents are very rare. Very rare, very rare, very rare, very rare. Once in a while, it happens, but not that common as like the road transport. Can you get to look at the disadvantages of railway transport? One, it is expensive to construct. For example, the standard gauge railway, Kenya, we use around 40 billion, right, to construct the standard gauge railway, right? Then look at accidents. They are also very rare, but always fatal when they occur. When they occur, very fatal, right? As compared to road transport. And also, diesel engines emit a lot of smoke. As I had shown you earlier, let me take you back to that image again. As I had shown you earlier, you can get to see there's a lot of smoke being emitted, right? That is bringing about air pollution. So when it comes to a disadvantage of railway transport, they emit a lot of smoke leading to air pollution. But again, let us get to look at what is the impact of railway transport. How has it impacted the life of people? So one, it has promoted urbanization. Towns have developed as a result of railway transport. Look at Nairobi as a center. Look at Syokimau as a center, right? Look at Voi as a center. Look at Kisumu as a city. They all developed as a result of railway transport. And now there is this city that is there is this town that is developing now, the Naivasha port, right? It's a dry port. Remember, that is where the trains deposit their cargo. So it is as a result of railway transport. And also, it has led to international trade. Now goods can be transported within regions of different places. For example, Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, we use the train. So it has made trade easier. And also, it has led to industrial revolution in Europe, as raw materials could be transported easily to industrial and finished products to markets. Look at the agricultural products from South America, right? They were to be taken from South America all along to Europe. They used the trains, and that case, it promoted industrial revolution. And also, it helped the colonists to establish effective control over their colonies through quick movement of administrators and troops. The main issue, right, of constructing the Kenya-Uganda Railway, it was for easier transportation of the colonial troops, for easier administration. And also, it has led, or that the railway transport has offered employment to many people, right? We have got the caretakers, we have got the mechanics, those people who make sure that they are safe conditioned, the train. So it has created employment to a number of people. Now, can you get to look at work to do? Can you name other three towns in Kenya that have developed as a result of the railway? And also, can we get to discuss the impact of railway transport to the people of East Africa? And in this case here, in question number two, where you discuss the impacts, can you get to look at the negative impacts? How have the railway transport impacted the people of East Africa negatively? And now for our reference, can we get to refer to Evolving World History from Form 2, the University of Oxford Press. And as always, this is Elimu TV, your favorite learning channel, where you watch and learn. Get in touch with us through our SMS line, through our Facebook page, and also through our Twitter handle. Thank you so much. See you in the next class.